say of decomposed matter is what oil is. So it gives strong evidence to the existence of fast, doesn't it? But do you see that all of that is only occurring in this instant? In this pure awareness? That there really is no fast? All seeing the past is there nothing more than concept occurring in this presence that is the only reality? Is here and now presence that is the only reality? Are we with it? It's happening now.
Yeah.
It never happened as we ordinarily consider it as happening. Or at the time that it seemed to have been happening, it was happening now, and there's only now and we think things happening. Do you get it? Fossils? Fossils are only happening now. You say, well, they seem to be the imprint of something that happened before. But you see, in this pure awareness, there is no before, and there is no after. It's only here and now. Are we here and now? Abiding in this here and now, as the here and now, is the only reality. The one reality. The one truth. There is no time. Time is only a concept. It's only an illusion. And if we buy into the notion of time, then that buying into the notion of time separates, apparently, in consciousness, the pure awareness of consciousness from the pure awareness and gives rise to this seeming identification with time and space that does not actually happen. All is only happening in the kingdom. There is no past as such. You can't see it. No one can show you. You can't show yourself in past. You might have a mask, the memory, that's the mind. But there's no past. And really, when we really get this, look how free it is, because we're not at the effect of anything that we are. Usually at the effect of that we say we did, that we have remorse and so forth about. Not to say that we shouldn't have remorse about actions that we have perpetrated, perhaps incorrectly against some being in the present, but we say that's already gone, and it's the state that we may still be identified with that is producing that quality in consciousness in the present. And so drop that quality, drop that pattern of conditioning, and you may need a pure awareness to do it. Am I making myself clear to you? Are we getting this? This is very seldom ever considered. What I'm describing is all. Even to describe and to hear what is being described in a matter of speaking requires consciousness expressing as mind. But prior to this consciousness that is expressing as mind is the awareness that it is. And this awareness that is what we all are. And this is what needs to be and wants to be known. It's this prior knowing that we are awareness as awareness before awareness conceptualizes itself as the consciousness or the thought I am. It's the pure I am, the pure knowing, before it conceptualizes itself as the thought or the concept that I am. You all get the difference? So here's where we want to remain and be cognizant, ever cognizant, ever present as the presence of the pure and as the pure awareness itself. Remaining in and as and functioning from the pure awareness itself. Everything else is the conceptualization. All else are concepts. I mean by and my and you and this and your and he and her, his and hers, and she and him, and all of this is just concept of mind. It's a manifestation of mind, which all occurs instant, you might say quickly after the fact. But that's only in time. It's after the fact. Before and after, there is no before and after in the pure awareness. Well, there is no time in the pure awareness. Just settle in. Let go into an as. Remain cognizant of as. Pure awareness. The timeless, faceless, formless awareness. Pure being. Everything else is conceptual. It is the knowing, it is the seeing is what we are. Not an I that is seeing, not an I that is knowing, it is true knowing. Without an I that knows. It's true seeing without an I that sees. It's pure being without an I that is. As Bhagavad Gita says, if we follow the inquiry all the way back into the pure awareness that arises out of this pure awareness, or let's say it doesn't arise because that's time and space too. You with that? So it doesn't arise, it's just observed, it's known. This prior I, and it's I hyphen I hyphen. I, you know, that continuous, consistent awareness itself, pure awareness shining. And this pure awareness shining like the sun, without any break, with no gaps, no spacing, no parts, no pieces. Ever present as it is. Always, already present as it is. Ever present as it is. It's pure awareness. And when we say as it, it takes an eye to talk about it, but it's not the eye that is talking about it. Are we getting there? So it's just resting, remaining poised, remaining present in and as and from this awareness, which is timeless, spaceless, formless, pure being itself. Without beginning, without ending, unchanging, without any support, without any precedent, nothing prior to it, It is the thoughtless soul. It is the uncaused cause of all that is. Now, we can't encompass it. It can't be encompassed. It's prior to everything. It cannot be modified, changed in any way. Are we with it? This is what we are. And this that we are is infinite and eternal. So you might call it, get acquainted with yourself. Who would get acquainted with that that we are that is infinite and eternal without beginning and ending? Then we could say, like the very philosophers of, for example, Paul in the Bible, oh, death, where is thy sting? No, this is death. This is awareness that is prior to everything. We all have that is the all-encompassing, the all-contained, but uncontained awareness. Again, these are just words, but again, the words are only pointers to this quality, indicators of this quality, of this presence. And what's significant and what is important is to not lose sight of, ever remembering, ever abiding as, and from this awareness at all times. Never losing sight of it.